Good morning, students. Today we will discuss the changing world of visual arts, that is 8th class topic. In this video we will discuss about the new popular Indian art. And photographing India. Photographing India. In my previous video, I have told you that this topic can be divided under some subtopics, like the first is scroll painting. The second is traditional scroll painting, or we can say traditional themes of scroll paintings. Today we will discuss about changing theme of scroll painting. After that we will discuss about, or we can say ki we will study about the differences between Kalighat painters and Calcutta art studio. Calcutta art studio, and later on study of paintings made by Kalighat painters and Calcutta art studio. After that we will discuss about the photographic India. Photographing India. As I have told you earlier, the painting on a long roll of paper that could be rolled up is known as scroll painting. And in our previous videos we have seen some phases of the new popular Indian art, like the theme used by scroll painters and three-dimensional scroll painting. In 19th century, scroll painters used mythological themes, but after the 1840s, we can see a new trend within the Kalighat artists, their taste, values, social norms and customs were changing rapidly. Kalighat artists responded to the world around and produced paintings on social and political themes. Many of the late 19th century Kalighat paintings depict social life under British rule. Often the artists mocked at the changes they saw around, ridiculing the new taste of those who spoke in English and adopted Western habit, dressed like sahibs, smoked cigarettes or sat on chairs. They made fun of the westernized babus, criticized the corrupt priests and warned against women moving out of their homes. They often expressed the anger of common people against the rich and the fear many people had about dramatic changes of social norms. Like we can see this picture, look this picture carefully. This is made by Kalighat painters. At first Kalighat painters used mythological themes, but later on they changed their themes and now they were making pictures, they were making paintings on social and political life of British and colonial people. Like this painting is a typical example of how Patois depicted English life in India. This painting shows an Englishman on an elephant hunting a tiger And this was made in mid 19th century, watercolor on paper. This painting is a typical example of how Patuas depicted English life in India. In the colonies, Englishmen loved to hunt. They saw hunting as a sport that could demonstrate their courage and manliness. Somewhere, Kalighat painters were presenting the taste and values of British people during the time of 19th century. They also changed material which was used by them in earlier. Like initially the images were engraved in wooden blocks, the carved blocks were inked, pressed against paper, and then the woodcut prints that were produced were colored by hand. In this way, many copies could be produced from the same block. By the late 19th century, mechanical printing press were set up in different parts of India, which allowed prints to be produced in even large numbers. These prints could therefore be sold shop at cheaper prices. Even the poor could easily buy them. Like we can see, the material, changed material which was used by Kalighat painters, initially they were using wooden blocks, carved blocks, this was inked and pressed against paper. And colored by hands. But in late 19th century, mechanical printing press was set up and this produced image at cheaper rates. And images could be produced in a large number. Now the question arises, were only poor painters and artists indulged in the work of making paintings? No. Besides poor painters and artists, middle class Indian artists were also indulged in the work of making paintings. They set up printing presses and produced print for a wide market. They were trained in the British art schools in new methods of life study. And in 19th century, new method of painting, that was life study, came into existence. Let me discuss what is life study. Study of human figures from living models who pose for the artists is known as life study. When any figure gives poses for making any painting, this is known as life study. And one of the most successful of these presses that was set up in late 19th century in Calcutta was Calcutta Art Studio. In Calcutta Art Studio, people were going to be trained in life study and in oil painting also. It produced lifelike images of eminent Bengali personalities as well as mythological pictures. What was the difference between the pictures which were painted by Kalighat painters and painters of Calcutta Art Studio? Look, these two pictures, this picture was made by Kalighat painters. And this picture was made by Calcutta Art Studio. In this picture, an Englishman, or we can say Babu, is presented on a chair. Whereas in this painting, mythological scene from the legend of Nal and Damayanti was painted. Mythological scene from Nal and Damayanti was painted by the painters of Calcutta Art Studio, and this was also made in 19th century, and this was also made in 19th century. Look these two pictures to make clear the differences between the paintings made by Kalighat painters and Calcutta Art Studio. As I have told you earlier, like this painting was also made in 19th century by Kalighat painters, whereas the painting of Nal and Damayanti was also made in 19th century by the painters of Calcutta Art Studio. Like in this painting, you can see the artists fear that the Babus will imitate the West and give up all that is valuable within the local culture. The Babu here is shown as a clownish figure, wearing shoes with high heels and sitting on a chair with ridiculously pointed legs. And now look this picture. In this picture, Nal and Damayanti were painted under natural surroundings. And when we see both these pictures, we can see that this picture is more realistic in comparison to the picture of Kalighat painters. This is more realistic in comparison to the paintings of Kalighat painters. The mythological images which were painted by Kalighat painters were not real and lifelike. They used watercolor and made three-dimensional images. Whereas the mythological pictures made by Calcutta Art Studio were realistic and located in picturesque landscape that can also be seen in the picture of Nal and Damayanti, setting with mountains, lakes, rivers and forest that is presented in this picture also. So we can say the pictures which were painted by the painters of Calcutta Art Studio were lifelike and more realistic in comparison to the pictures of Kalighat painters. Now we will see spread of nationalism. With the spread of nationalism, popular prints of the early 20th century began carrying nationalist message. In many of them, we can see Bharat Mata appearing as a goddess, carrying the national flag, or nationalist heroes sacrificing their head to the Mata and gods and goddesses slaughtering the British. When the feeling of nationalism was going to be spread at that time, we can see the popular figure in the form of Bharat Mata, famous personalities who sacrificed their life for India, or we can say national heroes. Look this figure of Kali. It was also produced by Calcutta Art Studio. In 1880s, this is an advertisement of an Indian brand of cigarette that was banned by British in 1905. In this picture, we can see the heads of British soldiers. Like these are the heads of British soldiers. Heads of British soldiers amongst the demons killed by the goddess. These kinds of religious images were also used to express nationalist ideas and inspire people against British rule. These pictures were used to spread the feeling of nationalism and somewhere to show their protest against British. Against British and their rules or laws. Now we will discuss about photographic India. Photographing India. We have seen how European painters created a variety of images of India. Such images were being produced by photographers as well. By the mid-19th century, photographers from Europe began traveling to India, taking pictures, setting up studios, and establishing photographic societies to promote the art of photography. Some of them were portrait painters who began taking photographs of imperial officials, presenting them as a figure of authority and power. Others traveled around the country, searching for ruined buildings and picturesque landscape, very much like some of the painters we have discussed. Yet others recorded moments of British military triumph. That was also a major theme of British painting. There were also those who recorded the cultural diversity of India in ways that tried to show how India was a primitive country. Actually, the British photographers were also willing to show the British supremacy and colonial power. That's why in their photographs we can also see that the British occupied a center position, whereas Indians occupied a shadowy image. When they captured the pictures of British victory, somewhere they wanted to show the supremacy of British military power by these pictures. Like in photographing studio, we can see first establishment of studios. And they choose different themes for their photography, like some choose British triumph, whereas others choose India as a primitive land. Third thing, they also wanted to show British power and supremacy. Look at this picture. This painting, this picture shows the horse regiment led by William Hodgson. This is William Hodgson. William Hodgson. Which played an important role in suppressing the 1857 revolt. And this photograph was taken by Phyllis Beardo in 1858. This photograph was taken by Phyllis Beardo in 1858. Notice the way the British officer is shown at the center, standing in an assertive and authoritative way while his soldiers gather around him. Somewhere this photograph is also showing the supremacy of British power. And besides these kinds of photographs, Indian photographers used to capture the photograph of nationalist demonstration. By the late 19th century, Indian photographers began taking pictures that often offer us a different image of India. They recorded the nationalist marches and meetings as well as the everyday life of the people. Somewhere we can see like the surroundings, the environment also changing the themes and the techniques of paintings and photographs. In our last and next video, we will discuss about the search for a national art.